lunar ring was proposed by a Japanese firm, Shimizu Corporation, to build a solar belt around the moon's equator. Is it possible to place solar panels in moon? How will you transmit the power generator from the moon to Earth? To get the answers, continue watching. Hi, I'm Benila. In today's video, I'm talking about lunar ring. On March 11, 2011, Japan experienced the strongest earthquake in its recorded history, which caused tsunami. The tsunami severely crippled the infrastructure of the country. In addition to thousands of destroyed homes, businesses, roads and railways, the tsunami destroyed Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. The nuclear disaster released toxic radioactive materials into the environment and forced thousands of people to evacuate their homes and businesses. Till then, Japan relied on nuclear reactors for 30% of its electrical power. After this tsunami, Japanese started opposing nuclear energy. This crisis led to a lot of research in alternate clean energy production. That's when Shimizu Corporation proposed lunar ring. This adventurous plan involves building a ring of solar cells around the moon's equator. Why did they choose moon? Moon does not have any atmosphere. It means there will be no weather or clouds that could affect the efficiency of the solar panel. And we can enjoy 24/7 continuous electricity generation from the moon. The real question is, how can we build solar ring in moon? Do we have to carry the solar cells from Earth and fix it there with the help of robots? The circumference of the equator of the moon is 11,000 km. To fill the circumference with solar cells, we need massive number of solar cells. So it's not an efficient way to carry solar cells from Earth. What about just sending the materials from Earth to construct solar cells? That is also not cost efficient. Instead, if we get the materials from the moon itself, that would be a perfect solution. Silicon, aluminium and iron can be chemically extracted from lunar soil for the fabrication of solar cells. Lunar soil can also be used to make concrete. Robots would play the primary role in building lunar ring. These robots would be remotely controlled from Earth. A team of astronauts would support the robot on site. A concrete ring will be constructed on the moon's equator and then the solar panels will be placed on this concrete layer. The lunar ring would initially have a width of few kilometers but could be extended up to 400 kilometers wide. These solar panels collect sunlight and convert it into electricity. Now, how will you transmit this power? We can't construct power cables between moon and Earth. So, this power is transmitted through microwaves and laser. Let's see in detail about this. The produced electricity is transmitted through the cables to the near side of the moon where it is converted into microwaves and laser. What is actually the near side of the moon? We know that moon rotates on its axis and revolves around the Earth. But we can see only one side of the moon from Earth. Now you may wonder why. If moon rotates on its axis, we must be able to see all the sides of the moon. But the thing is, the moon orbits the Earth's surface every 27.3 days and rotates on its axis also every 27.3 days. Let me explain this clearly. Now, this is the side visible to the Earth. If the moon rotates and revolves at the same speed, then in all position, only one side of the moon is visible. This visible side is called the near side of the moon. From this near side, the antennas will transmit the power to the Earth. At Earth, the microwave power and laser power are converted back into electricity and is supplied to the grid. Microwaves can pass through rain, clouds, dust and smoke. But there is a small health risk in this process. A person standing in the microwave beam could absorb 2% of the incident power and feel slightly warmer. To avoid this risk, people should be restricted from this zone. But this doesn't create any hazards to insects or birds flying through it. Even though everything seems to be easy, there are many practical difficulties. First one is fund. You might have guessed it already. This project is going to cost a lot. The company needs a lot of investors. On the technical side, even though the solar panels are not affected by the bad weather, they must face solar dust. The company should find the solution for this. Shimizu Corporation has announced that they will start the construction by 2035. But we'll have to wait and see if that is feasible. If you like this video, you might also like the space-based solar power plant. Thank you so much for watching. See you in my next video.